I think that Olivia is running because the prospect of freedom and happiness is just too enticing. She's waited so long for hope to be instilled in her that she just can't wait one more minute to go find happiness. Running is also something that we keep seeing in the Looniverse, when girls are in pursuit of something that they desire. In Hi Hi, as Kim Lip sings, "Long-awaited love, if that's really you," various girls get ready to go running. But Olivia was the one to sing, "I need just a little bit more time," which alluded to her hindrances to join YYBY and Luna in the lore. Then Chu hits her high note, and all the girls go running after what they've long awaited for, each other. So running, again, is the Luna girls' main means of transportation when they are after a long-awaited desire. Olivia's been waiting for this since March of 2018, and it's been a long time coming. Now, let's discuss the scar on Olivia's neck. We've never seen it before, but we know that when Eve picked up the stuffed wolf, Olivia's representative animal, out of her claw machine, it was by the neck. And the neck slipped out when Eve dropped Olivia down to Earth again, against Olivia's will. This scar is a reflectioning of that happening. Throughout history, scars have had various meanings, most often linked to men and their rites of passage. The ways in which scars are obtained also have an associated meaning. If a scar is by fighting for a cause, then that scar was a symbol of honor. If branded because you refused to submit to a war draft, then you were seen as a coward. Scarring emulates masculinity, in that they are physical proof of the journey and adversity men had to endure through hunting, fighting, and protecting their young and family. Again, I'm not trying to perpetuate a gender norm, as each of us have varying levels of femininity and masculinity depending on who we are. But we can't ignore these gender norms and how they affected connotations and symbolisms in literature and legend of the past, just because it is not the same as it is in the current age. Luna has even utilized a lot of imagery and symbolism associated with masculinity in their lore before, which is great. It shows young girls that they can achieve success and self-love in anything that they do, but still retain a level of femininity that they possess. Not only that, but they show all fans that they can like what they like and do what they do, no matter how society associates it. Getting back on topic, Olivia's scar was obtained through a somewhat embarrassing or infuriating circumstance. She was selfishly pushed to come to terms with the other aspects of herself when she wasn't quite ready, and as a result, fell apart and was dropped once more. This scar was obtained in Eden, a place that is supposed to be secure and perfect, a true paradise. But the scar holds a great deal of pain for Olivia. This scar proves Olivia's identity as the angry girl that is suffering, and we know that it literally is Olivia's because we see it with our own two eyes. But the way she obtained that scar, the dropping from the claw machine or being dropped by Eve, is what establishes Olivia's identity in the first place. Olivia gaining the scar made her view herself as a failure and made her angry and egotistic afterwards. This scar on her neck has a double meaning. Not only is it a physical wound, it is an emotional wound as well, just like the broken wing that Gohan helped mend. In English, the saying to cut your throat means to behave in a way that will harm yourself, especially because you are very offended or angry about something. Very fitting for our angry, upset girl Olivia to have a scar on her neck, especially with this new context. In fact, in many different works of literature, neck wounds are often an externalization of psychological wounds. It symbolizes lasting trauma. We all have scars, though, and we should never be ashamed of them. They're a symbol of our strength, and it means that the hurt is now over, as everything is healed. Similarly, now that Gohan has mended Olivia's wings, renewed her desire of happiness, and changed the past in her favor, Olivia's scar has finally healed over. We Orbits all know of Olivia's past, as we all see the pain that she has endured and how emotionally fragile she was. We felt her anger, her loneliness, and her resentment for the other side of herself. She had been overcome with negativity, which heavily conflicted with the objectives of the positive aspects of YYBY. Now, when we watch her confidently move out of the black of the tunnel and into the light of day, and rip off the collar from her neck to unveil that healed scar in full, we can be sure that this new comeback will allow for Olivia to grow immensely. It should be obvious, but collars represent constraints. Just like Hassel sitting in the nest, being a caged bird, Olivia's confinement is the collar. Collars, with leashes, are worn by dogs to keep them at bay, and to restrain them. If you left a searing steak in front of a hungry dog, just out of the chain's reach, that would be cruel. But that's exactly what happiness was to Olivia. I'm sure if you're an American student like myself, You've read at least one novel by Nathaniel Hawthorne. He's an extremely famous early American author who's written works such as The Scarlet Letter, The House of Seven Gables, and my personal favorite, Young Goodman Brown. He is also well known for his quote on happiness. Happiness is a butterfly, which when pursued, is always just beyond your grasp, but which, if you will sit down quietly, may alight upon you. Hawthorne is essentially saying that for us to truly gain happiness, we need to stop seeking it. It isn't just some magical thing that is granted to us once we get that perfect car, that new purse, or that new job promotion. Happiness comes to us when we live our life within loving ourselves and our capabilities. We don't have to chase that elusive butterfly. For it, when we remain still and stop running through life constantly pining after it, will come to us. Aren't you your happiest when you're loving? Loving to paint, to swim, to sing, to talking with friends, to finishing a really good book? Aren't we happiest when we indulge in our simplest desires? We don't need to rush through life, always contemplating on why we can't have this, why we can't do that. We need to just stop and look at our direct world in a rose-colored lens. A certain wolf and butterfly also saying about their life being rosy. The only way to be confident and loving is to remove our inhibitions, tear away any layer of us that hinders us from full potential. Children don't just keep their baby teeth in because pulling it out would hurt. If they did, they would be hindering their growth. We can't just tell ourselves that we will never be like who we envy, and we can't let ourselves become jealous of those who have figured out what they want to get. We just have to stop, be still, and see where our wills will take us. Isn't it amazing to see this being done by the girl with arguably the most scars? Olivia can do anything now, as Gowan has mended her wings and healed her scars. She can stand still and wait for that gentle little butterfly to land on her shoulder. She's now enlightened, and this new comeback, to me, could be an entire reversal of the roles of YYBY. We saw a shift with their dynamic in Gowan taking Olivia's isolated spot on the balcony, so what huge effects could result from this minor change in the butterfly? The only thing that has truly puzzled me thus far is where Kinlip and, perhaps, the rest of the Odd Eye girls come in. In this specific teaser, Olivia passes by the girl that represents Eve, wearing headphones like the ones that she ripped out of Jinsoul's ear in Sweet Crazy Love. Sweet Crazy Love was also the music video where we saw in the eye diagram the butterfly, plane, and bird that connected Gowan, Hassel, and the plane in Iceland. That's what we saw in X2X. We know that, in doing so, Olivia inspired Jinsoul to kill her fish, which represented her old self, in order to enter the Lunaverse as her new self. And Jinsoul did the same for Olivia and Egoist. Even Olivia's new hair has dyed blue ends, which is, as we know, Jinsoul's color. Not to mention, we saw an underpass in the Starlight Cinema Theory video, where Eve approached Cherry with an apple, inviting her to sin. We know she took up that offer, as we saw her in Gowan's One and Only music video, with Eve and Shu, trying to get Gowan to become enlightened as to who she was and her role in the Lunaverse. And whenever we see blood moons, we often associate it with Kinlip, our girl who summoned the last half of Luna. Kinlip was a huge part in the X1X teaser, where she had her odd eye and where she also turned around to have a metamorphosis. After all the material released, I think that she most definitely has a big part in the lore. I talked about her and Hassel's connection in my last video, citing the concrete as their color wheel opposites, similar motifs, and paralleling lyrics. What could come next from Kinlip and the other Odd Girls could be so entirely different and unexpected, and I truly believe it will be. Now, everyone is so mysterious. We thought we knew more about every girl than we actually did, and now that we've gone back in the timeline, fluidity is going to affect the makeup of every subunit. Solid, liquid, gas. It's going to rattle every notion or theory we thought is confirmed. Now with Olivia's struggles being revealed and mended, what about Gowan? Will her sacrifices be worth it? Will she have formed a new subunit? And what about Yojin? Still, I keep asking, what about Yojin in every XX series teaser? She is so mysterious, and she's gonna have to come in at some point. And I think this part of the lore is gonna be the part where she really, really has true deep meaning. So many questions plague my mind still. One thing we know for certain, though, is that we are on Earth with a girl who landed there after being dropped. She's released her inhibitions, entered the light, and nothing is holding this little wolf girl back. Nothing. Now that the butterfly rests gently on our baby wolf's shoulder, it no longer lilts about. The butterfly has landed to rest. Gowan has granted happiness. And Olivia's finally, finally, going to get that.
Happiness is a butterfly. We should catch it while dancing high. Lose myself in the music, baby. Every day is a lullaby. Try to catch it like lightning eye. Sing it into my music, I'm crazy. If he's a serial killer, then what's the worst that can happen to a girl who's already hurt? I'm already hurt. If he's as bad as they say, then I guess I'm cursed. Looking into his eyes, I think he's already hurt. He's already hurt. If he's a serial killer.
Thank you for watching. If you do like my videos, please like and subscribe, and leave a comment to add to the conversation. Comeback's gonna be so super soon, and I just cannot wait for this next installation on Allure, seriously. These XX teasers are so deep, and I'm loving the collective minds that are coming together to try and decode this. Again, thanks for watching. This is Twinfish, signing off.